Hi, I'm Jim Hammond from Arab, Alabama. Been a custom knife maker since 1977. First became interested in custom knives my senior year of college when I was going to Clemson University. And a friend of mine showed me a custom knife by a maker from there in Spartanburg, and I was fascinated by the workmanship, the artistry in it, and even though it was only $85, it was to me a work of art with the craftsmanship that it had. And that was the inspiration. I came home that February to the first Southeastern Handmade Knife Show in Birmingham, Alabama. Met a lot of wonderful makers, got a lot of inspiration. Came home after 4 years of paying out-of-state tuition at Clemson to announce to my folks that I wanted to make knives. And you can imagine how that response went over. But my dad said to give it a try for a year and see what worked. And during that time, I've never been ahead of orders, and being in 1977, that's going on over 32 years ago now. And I've been doing this full time with customers all over the world. And as a lot of makers did early on, started making hunting knives just to learn the art. But in 1981, I felt a calling to work on some more specialized knives, and that's the tactical field. At that time, the tactical knife market did not even exist as such. But I sought out the advice in 1981 of the Navy SEALs. I thought they were the most accomplished and well-trained in custom knife and knife fighting and so forth. And it was at that time that I developed the SEALTAC, Sea Air Land Tactical Model, with them. And things were off and running. From that point on, I worked a lot with them and a number of other special warfare groups over the years, and they came to me with their needs. Some of the guys from Delta Group came down, and we worked on special projects for their jungle knives. And one of the most popular custom knives that I make at this time, I developed back during Desert Storm. I worked with Arsenio James Advincula, one of the, quote, founding fathers of the United States Marine Corps, the gentleman who created the martial arts training program for the Marine Corps. And with one of his students, with whom I developed the SEALTAC with years before, we worked together to incorporate Jim's designs into a piece that embodied all of his years as a retired master sergeant and also one of the top martial arts instructors in the world, combined it together to create a knife that would embody his training techniques. And that knife is one that's a style knife that incorporates four different grip distances with it, different grip positions. You have a forward grip for working. You have first position grip. You have a second position grip that the hand can extend back on when it's being used, and it can extend back for increased chopping at the rear. The grip flares out at the front of the grip for a stop because Jim utilizes what he calls a modified hammer grip. And it has an area here, a capture cavity on the back of the blade for reinforced cut and also for utility work. A set of serrations to prevent the hand from sliding forward on the edge. Has a recurved edge for deeper slashing in a cut, and a double step guard on the double step top edge for maximum cutting efficiency. And as far as the customs go in a piece like that, form and function go hand in hand. There's no bells and whistles that I put on my pieces. For example, on the ones that developed for Columbia River over the years, they've done the SEALTAC, they've done other pieces of mine, the Cobra Gold, numerous pieces over the years. One of the other utility pieces that Columbia River has manufactured has been the ABC, stands for All Bases Covered. And that is a utility combination series that incorporates both the Tanto style pointed blade as well as a blunt tip safety style blade for people doing whitewater work, search and rescue, dive rescue, and so forth. They come in a combination sheath where it can be mounted left-handed or right-handed, the way it locks into the sheath. It's tension adjustable, goes in and locks either way. It can be mounted and carried upside down on the safety harness on a whitewater vest. It can also be mounted with leg straps on the legs through these slots with neoprene straps, or it can also be inverted and worn as a neck knife as well. And the knife also locks in the sheath, handle on, handle off. So it's up to the user's preference if he wishes to make it an all-steel knife for ease of concealability, or if he wishes to keep the handles on for greater grip comfort. And having done this now for 32 years, a lot has changed in the market But the one thing about Columbia River, when I first began working with them, goes back as the first maker. And that's in around 1994. And it's been a wonderful experience to see them evolve and become one of the great cutlery companies in the world. My website, jimhammondknives.com. Their website, CRKT.com.